A very good morning. So today let us discuss about MOSFET, that is metal oxide field effect transistor. Some basic about MOSFET is it is a voltage control device. So device is controlled by voltage. Till this, before invention of MOSFET, the devices are starting from diode. Then when two diodes connected back to back, it form a transistor, and when two transistor connected back to back forms an SCR, and when two SCR connected back to back, they form triac. All these devices are current control device. Okay, so they are turned on and turned off by electric current, whereas this MOSFET is the first person who was voltage control device, which means turn on and turn off is done by voltage applied across the gate. Okay, let us go in. So in today's session we will see about what and all modes of MOSFET. You have two types, which is called depletion and enhancement. Then we will discuss about the construction of MOSFET, how the MOSFET is being constructed. Then we will see into something called as threshold voltage, then VI characteristics and transfer characteristics, and finally we will discuss about channel length modulation. So classification, it is being classified into depletion mode and enhancement mode. So these are the two modes. Okay, under depletion mode you have N channel and P channel. Again under enhancement mode you have N channel and P channel. Usually students have a tendency to muck up the symbols, but that is not required. Okay, so when you see MOSFET, it is called metal oxide. One side you will have metal, in between you have oxide, then you have semiconductor material. So there is three things which you have to remember. The metal is nothing but your gate terminal. Okay, so first you draw a line and mention it as gate. Then oxide, which is nothing but there is an isolation between this metal and this semiconductor. This isolation is done by this oxide, so that is why in symbol there is a gap. Okay, this gap is nothing but that is filled with oxide. So gate, you have this gate is metal, so that is what, so that is what this metal. Then comes your oxide, then you have semiconductor material. Okay, in this semiconductor material, whether the semiconductors are connected or they are open. So you can see here depletion, which means normally there will be a connection between a drain and source. So you can see the diagram. So starts from drain, there is a path and it is closing via source. So these device, that is depletion mode MOSFET device, will be initially on. So only if you give gate voltage, it will be turned off. You try to understand, in case of depletion, normally it is in conduction. By giving gate pulse, I am depleting or I am turning off. So that is why the line is continuous here. Okay, so again we all know either it can be n-type or p-type. So the material of semiconductors, whether it is n-type or p-type, it has been classified. Now you please come to this enhancement mode. Enhancement, so normally it will be in off. I am trying to enhance it, which means bringing from off to on. So now if you see here, see, you can visualize from drain you don't have any connection with respect to source, so there is a cut in between. So this cut, it is been joined and to make a path for current flow from drain to source by help of gate. So when you give a gate potential, with that gate potential this device will get turned on. Again you have N channel as well as P channel in enhancement. Normally used MOSFETs are enhancement MOSFET we will use. We will not, only for some application alone we go for depletion, and most probably we will use enhancement, and this we will always go for N channel enhancement MOSFET. So among the available various modes, we are going to discuss about this N channel enhancement MOSFET. Okay, so now we have to go for construction. So in construction, what we do is first you take an p-type material. So you take a p-type material, so that is what we've taken here. So this box, this triangle box, is p-type semiconductors. Okay, you take a p-type semiconductors. The thing is, this p is lightly doped, which means we all know what is called as doping. Doping is nothing but adding external impurities to your pure semiconductor to make the person a conducting material. Only by adding impurities, the semiconductors are behaving like a conductor. Pure semiconductors are insulators. Okay, so you are adding impurities, but the amount of adding impurity is less in this p region. Okay, next what you have to do is you go here. See, this is p-type material. Now you have put a hole here as well as hole here. Try to remove this portion, then fill it with N. So that is your step 2. Diffused with heavily doped region, N region, on both sides. So we are able to see this region and this region, what and all present is being removed, which means this P in this region is removed. That we call it as etching. What we will do is we will give a paper over here. There you will have opening at this two. We will try to pass UV light. That UV light will try to burn. So again, then we will remove that paper and we will clean it and wash it. So you will have two well-like structure. There you fill it with N-type material. So that is your step 2. Now we have taken P as a substrate. N has been done. Now we have to coat SiO2. This ashed lines area is nothing but SiO2. So above your P-type material, I am coating with SiO2, which is nothing but an dielectric. Okay, now this plays a major role. So once coating is done, next is you have to make contacts. Contact is again by process of keeping UV light over here. We try to remove, then you place a metal contact and mark it as one end. You mark it as source and another end you mark it as drain. Okay, now you should have a path from drain to source. Drain will be always at higher potential, so drain to source. But conventionally speaking, only from a negative can flow. So flow will be from source to this N plus, this region, this N plus, again it has to go out. Now what, how the device is turned on? The last step of our construction is, over the center you have to put the metallization and name it as gate. So once you fix this metal, this is metal layer, then your gate, your construction is over. So normally what happens is, this region is p-type material, so you don't have any electrons. Since it is lightly even doped, you don't have any electrons here. So the electron from the source cannot pass to your drain. So when this electron from source will start flow is when you are giving a supply to gate. So when you give a negative supply here, you get an electron here. If you give positive, negative will be induced. If you give negative, positive will be induced. That depends upon the type of, if it is N-type and P-type. This channel is P-type. Okay, so this is P-type. So for P-type, you have to give positive here and negative will be generated. For N-type, you have to give negative here, positive will be here and the device will get turned on. Only difference, see, difference between this N channel and P channel is nothing but the channel region. What type of channel which you are going to form? Here what channel you have to form? You have to form an N channel. Another case, P channel. So when you want to have a N channel here, you have to give positive here. So when you give positive here, automatically negative. This is like a capacitance effect. Okay, like capacitance. What you say, a capacitance is two polarity separated by a dielectric. The potential apply here will be reversed in this region. So if you give positive here, negative. If you give negative here, it is positive. This is with respect to construction. Okay, so now you have done your entire part. So now let us go on to your operation. So when your device will be turned on is when the gate to source voltage, see, gate to source voltage and another voltage is drain to source voltage. Drain to source voltage is to allow the electron to flow, and this flow of electron is controlled by a person called gate. So gate to source voltage only will make the device to turn on. Okay, so this threshold voltage is nothing but the minimum voltage which is required to turn on your device. See, it can be shown here. So when you go on increasing your gate voltage, when you go on increase gate voltage, at a particular gate voltage, the channel has been formed. Okay, I will repeat this video so that you can understand. So voltage is increasing at this particular instant. You can visualize here that there is a joining, and this joining is nothing but channel has been formed. So for this case, 0.45 is a threshold voltage. So when the voltage of this gate to source is crossing 0.4, automatically channel will be created and the device will be turned on. This is usually asked, frequently asked, two mark question. So you should know what is called as threshold voltage. Is commonly abbreviated as VTH, is the minimum gate source voltage that is needed to create the conducting path between the source and drain terminal. Okay, so this is, then we move on to VI characteristics. VI characteristics is nothing but characteristics between voltage and current. What is the voltage applied and what is the current flow? See, VI characteristics is on output side, which means when you are going to give, I have already told, we are connecting two supply. One supply is between gate and source, another is between drain and source. So when you are connecting between this drain and source, there will be voltage across VDS. So for this change in VDS, what is the current which is flowing? That is called as VI characteristics, output characteristics. Okay, so you will change your VDS. For change in VDS, there will be change in ID. Okay, that is called as VI, and this purely depends upon only the gate voltage which you are applying. Only gate will decide about the current flow. This fellow is going to control only based upon this gate voltage. So that is why I told MOSFET is a voltage control device. When you give a voltage across your gate to source, that only decides the operation of the device. Only this gate voltage will decide. Okay, so let us keep at a particular value of gate voltage which is less than this particular line. You have a line here. So if I am keeping gate voltage less than this, what will happen is device will not turn on. Or in other words, when your gate voltage is less than the minimum threshold voltage, that means we have seen threshold voltage here. If your gate voltage is less than threshold voltage, you land into a region called cutoff region. Even though this region will be very small, but for your understanding, we have extrapolated this region and we are trying to show as a big region, but this much big in length, it will not be there. Just for understanding, only thing is when your voltage, that is gate to source voltage, is less than threshold voltage, the region of operation will be cutoff region. In other words, there won't be any for change in VDS, there won't be any change in I. That is the point you have to highlight. For change in VDS, there won't be any change in ID in cutoff region. Okay, let us move on to the next region, which is called ohmic region or linear region. This is the region where we are going to operate. So depending upon the current required, you give a gate voltage. So that is what our main and purpose behind a particular device. So depending upon my gate voltage, there will be change in drain to source current, which is nothing but ID. So you can see here, when I keep my gate voltage at a particular value, this is my current. So this is the current which I am able to get. So if I go on change my gate to source voltage, obviously the current increases. So what we have started saying, flow of electrons. So flow of electron is controlled by a person called gate voltage. So that beginning to flow a drain current with a linear response to the voltage behavior like a variable resistor. So when you see this ohmic region, when I am increasing the gate voltage, what happening is resistance is decreasing. So initially resistance was little bit high, so current was less. Then the resistance starts to decrease. When the resistance start to decrease, your current will start to increase. So the thing is, you have to talk with respect to conductance. So conductance will increase if there is decrease in this particular person. So when you are operating in ohmic region, you are able to control the flow of electron. So next to this ohmic region is saturation. So you can visualize here, see, once the current reaches this particular instant, thereafter if you vary the voltage, there is no variation in current. Current remains constant.
for that particular gate voltage. If you increase the gate voltage, again the current will increase, and this increase in current again land into a saturation where further increase in your voltage will not have any variation in current. So okay, this is the region where MOSFET is completely on and there is no condition for increase in current beyond that particular value for a particular value of gate source voltage. So when you are saying about saturation, you fix a gate voltage at a particular value, for that gate voltage you will have a current, and that current has reached its maximum value, thereby further increase in voltage will not have any change in your output current. So that is called saturation region. There is one more region which we all should know, is semiconductor is not a conductor. At a one particular instant this fellow will try to break down. That is called as breakdown region. See, you are not supposed to go on increase VDS. It is like a dam. A dam have a capacity of storing water, but if your water level is going beyond a particular value, which you have mean to say your potential is increasing, when the potential increase beyond a particular value, the entire dam will get collapsed and your device or your dam will fail. Here our device will burn. So you are not supposed to increase this. So if you are increasing beyond this particular value, automatically what happens is very high current starts to flow. This very high current will leads to thermal runaway and your entire device will burn. So that is called as your breakdown region. Okay, so now we have seen about what is input characteristics. Now let us move on to transfer characteristics. From the word itself it is very clear, transfer. What you give on input and what you get it on output, what is being transferred from input side to the output side. From input you give it across gate voltage, output side you measure across ID current. I repeat, transfer characteristics is nothing but what you give it as an input and what you get it as output. For a device, you are talking about flow of electron. Flow of electron is between what two terminal, source to drain, or we call it as drain to source. So current is going to flow from drain to source. So this output current flow depends upon input. So when you draw a graph between input and output, that is nothing but transfer characteristics. So you can see here VGS, you are not supposed to interchange it as VDS, it is only VGS. So initially VGS is 0 and your current is also 0. I am gradually increasing my voltage till VT, that is threshold voltage, there won't be any output, that you have to indicate. So your transfer characteristics will be in 0 till your gate voltage reaches its threshold voltage. If it is crossing the threshold voltage, your device will start, thereby change in gate voltage will have change in ID. Okay, that is called as transfer characteristics. Usually they will ask, you have to tell ID remains 0, when it will be remain 0 till cutoff state, that is VGS as less than or equal to VT threshold voltage. This is because only then the channel will be formed. Only if you cross your threshold voltage, your channel will be formed. Once your channel is formed, your device will start conducting. Okay, now let us discuss with the channel length modulation. This is the last topic. So what is actually happening, that is, in actual case this won't be a straight line, that is saturation. In saturation region we say that further change in voltage, there won't be any change in current, that is what we say. But actually what is happening is there is small change in current. Even under saturation it will increase. This increase is due to the person called channel length modulation, that the transition to saturation mode occur because the channel get punched off, which means channel get comes and touch this particular drain, thereby your current remains constant. That is what is saturation we have called. But what happens is, actually speaking, due to this channel formation, and if you further increase your gate to if you increase drain to source voltage, this increase in voltage will leads to decrease in resistance. The resistance of the channel is proportional to the width of the length. So when you go on increasing this drain to source voltage, this channel length starts to reduce. But if this length starts to reduce, what happens is your resistance falls. So when your resistance falls, obviously we know current will increase. If there is no person to disturb the flow of electron, obviously the flow of electron will increase. So that is what is happening. So channel length modulation, if they ask, you have to tell the resistance of the channel is proportional to width to length ratio. Reduce the length leads to reduce the resistance and hence the higher current flow. Thus the channel length modulation means that the saturation drain current will increase slightly as the drain to source voltage increase. So only thing you have to remember is only slightly. You won't get more change. So you are not supposed to go for this method itself to increase your drain current. So drain current, you are not supposed to say that when I increase VDS, drain current will increase. That you are not supposed to say, because this change is very light and that is not going to affect. And only way by which you can increase your ID is by your gate to source voltage. So that is what is our conclusion. So with that, we will stop today a discussion about MOSFET. So MOSFET, I repeat, MOSFET is an voltage control device. So voltage given to your gate to source will decide the operation. After crossing a particular value, threshold value, your device will get turned on. Thereby, by changing the gate voltage, your ID current will change. Okay, so that is what about today's discussion. Even if you have any doubts or any clarification required, you can comment in the YouTube channel. Okay, thank you.